What up? I am Diskid, and I'm back with another reaction video to these TikToks, strange TikToks, weird TikToks, whatever TikTok y'all want to put it in, categories and whatnot. I'm not rapping. I wasn't rapping. Alright, but yo, make sure y'all please go check out my main page, Our Generations Entertainment, if y'all want to see some more content, you feel me? But yeah, for right now, let's jump straight into it. Y'all already know, because we already got little seizures pizza, you are.
Just a few weeks ago, Isabel Oakeshott, who's a journalist in the UK, she had access to WhatsApp messages between the Secretary of State for Health and other people in the cabinet. And it was a front page of the Telegraph newspaper at the beginning of the pandemic. And one of those messages revealed, we have to frighten the pants off the public. Something along those lines, right? So they wanted to create this fear. And when you're under... To force compliance. And when you're in a state of fear psychologically, Joe, two things happen. One is you're more likely to be controlled, right? And that's what they wanted. But also it inhibits your ability to engage in critical thinking.
That's facts. I ain't gonna lie, bro. There's a lot of us that can't really control what they're thinking right now. Because if you try to make a move, bro, that move is control.
Y'all, I am freaking out right now. There's a lot of unexplained things going on in the ocean right now. Hold on real quick. I do not trust them. Just watch this real quick for me.
You get to Mars by going through the ocean. You can't get to the bottom of the ocean because outer space is the ocean.
Now, what she just said just blew my mind. Now, there's a situation called the firmament. So we know that water is all around us. And it is said that this dome divided the sea into upper and lower sections. You can't cancel this out because they still haven't discovered 80% of the sea. Early civilizations believed that the ocean and the stars above were linked. I mean, just look. Mayan, Norse, Hindu, Hebrew, all of them. Now, we already know what spacesuits look like, but they look exactly like sea suits. I know once in your life you've heard of the Bermuda Triangle. Planes and people going missing in the ocean. There are black holes in the ocean. And I just know once in your life you've heard about sea monsters. When you see a comet, it looks like a boat soaring through water. What if these unexplained species in the ocean are actually aliens? If y'all have ever watched this movie Underwater, they went too deep and found the creature that don't even look like it's supposed to be from this earth. Or could it have just been a creature from space? Now you can say what you want, but I bet you we are not the only beings, only species, only creatures that are in this universe. It's just ironic that when they return to Earth, they're on water. I mean, I know I'm not tripping. And I know y'all heard of mermaids. So many unexplained things in the ocean. They're making more discoveries in space. Not really putting too much money or caring about what's going on the planet. Why? Because this sea stuff might have a lot of connections to space. And they not telling us. Y'all be safe, and I know I'm not the only person who feel this way.
Okay, so I want to add to that. Let's founder with your brain a little bit. So, check this. If I'm looking up into the sky, right? I'm looking underwater. Because, like, if some shit fall from the sky, right? Onto land. Does that mean that... Alright, so look, hear me out again. If they say some shit falling from the sky, right? And it hit... Say, alright, look, alright. Say if some shit fall from the sky, right? And it hit land, right? It hit land. Where did it come from? Did it come from down below? I'm not quite understanding a certain part of this whole fucking shit. Because you know what I mean? If some shit comes from the sky, like a meteoroid, right? Or like a star or whatever they say. I'm not even trying to sound ignorant. I'm dead ass, bro. Like, I understand what she trying. Let's just go to the next clip.
Everything they ever have told us is a lie. They tell us that our heart is a pump. Your heart is not a pump. Your heart is a valve. Your lungs is a pump that pumps the blood to the heart. The heart is a valve mechanism that controls the cardio output of blood. Everything they tell us about everything is a lie. They tell you your hair is just hair. No, our hair is non-ether hair. It is actually an extension of your nervous system. It is used to scan the environment, and it brings all of these different melanin neurotransmitters back to your skin to tell you whether to actually engage in the environment or take fight or flight and run away. We heal a lot of what you would call celebrities or stars, a whole lot of them. My name ring bells in the celebrity kingdom.
I know.
Ring bells. We done heal cancer. We done heal a lot of STDs with rappers, a whole lot of it's crazy STDs. We done got people off of opioids. We grew a thyroid back. We got rid of a case of HIV in the actual celebrity community. It's crazy the way they call me, and it's like, you got everything you want, but you missing your help.
My man's was on point with that one, bro. That's crazy. But when he said the HIV, first thing came to my mind was Magic Johnson.
What is the government so afraid of? The U.S. Navy sets off a 40,000-pound bomb in the Atlantic Ocean, 100 miles from the coast of Florida, saying that it was only a military exercise. However, looking at the footage of the explosion, it definitely didn't seem like a regular military exercise. Furthermore, it's known that there are unknown creatures or aliens living deep in the ocean. So, could it be possible that it wasn't a military exercise, but a cover-up to take out a deadly threat in the ocean? With this suspicious military exercise, many are asking.
I mean, it would make sense to try to destroy some shit underwater if they needed to, really. Just saying.
Young Will Smith knew what was going on.
Do you believe in government conspiracies?
Oh, absolutely.
No, I'm serious.
No, definitely. No, oh my God.
I know, I heard you did. Are you serious now?
Oh yeah, no, I'm very serious. You can't tell.
I read that you felt that the government was deliberately spraying cold germs in subways, was deliberately trying to make people ill with the AIDS virus. This is pretty serious stuff. Do you really feel that?
Well, that's a good question. Well, I'm with Barbara Walters now. Oh, that's a serious one. Okay, so I got to, now, because people are going to chase me after this.
Oh, just like they chased Martin Lawrence?
People are going to chase me. I believe that it is quite highly possible that the AIDS virus is a result of genetic warfare testing.
By American agents?
Absolutely.
Will.
By the way, this video is scripted and for entertainment purposes only. Stay weird.
I ain't gonna lie, it kind of looked like that interview was like kind of rehearsed when she said by Americans. Like, it just kind of looked like it was rehearsed in so many different ways. But that's crazy though, because he's not the only one that spoke on that. But let's keep it pushing.
Hey, you want to see something real creepy? May I ask you to look something up? Look up the
Denver Airport murals. You have probably seen the conspiracies about the Denver Airport and their mysterious murals. All throughout the Denver Airport, these disturbing murals were displayed. The murals actually tell the story of a one-world government taking over. In these murals, you can see soldiers dominating peace, cities in chaos, and nature caged. To the untrained eye, it's just art. But to some, it's a narrative, a story of a one-world government's rise. Some say it shows countries surrendering their power, paving the way for a single global ruling entity. And then there's the use of the rainbow flag. All throughout these murals, the thing that stays the same is this rainbow flag taking over. Some interpret it as a symbol of unity and acceptance, but others see a more ominous message, a unified world under one governing flag, using peace symbols to veil a dark intent. The different murals all connect into one piece of art. They tell the story of this rainbow defeating a large military man. And the strangest part is in the last mural. Here you can see in the last mural, the children are wrapping weapons up with all different country flags, and the rainbow flag is unrolling from the chaos. Art is subjective, but when murals potentially reflect world events, it's worth a second look. Curious for more? Follow for a deeper dive into the world's enigmas.
All I got to say with this one is, get right with God.
Government conspiracies that actually turned out to be true. Make sure you check out part one about the heart attack gun. In this video, we're going to talk about the Dead Baby Project. Now, this was called Project Sunshine, which is a really messed up name, and you'll realize why after I tell the story. So the original theory was that the government was stealing dead bodies to do radioactive testing. And the truth is, the government was stealing parts of dead bodies. But they specifically needed young tissue, so they were stealing from dead babies. These were all recently deceased babies or children, and they would take samples of their tissue and sometimes even their limbs. Each of these were collected without permission from grieving families. They did this to over 1,500 grieving families. It could be more, we'll just never know.
And to keep it a buck with you, that ain't the only thing that they taken from dead people. Taken from deceased bodies, even from birth. This stuff that they giving them to, this whole bunch of stuff. I ain't even gonna lie to y'all.
They are taking this down like crazy. Watch. Look what they're researching.
Taken down. I'm not allowed to have a camera in here, and I had to put it in a very uncomfortable place to sneak it in here. I'm inside of a top secret government research facility. You can see the grates in the floors. There are grates in the ceilings. What these grates are for, they move air in very quickly, fresh air.
What would they need that for?
And they take it up to the roof. They pump it back out outside after it's filtered, because without it, the air in here
is
contaminated very quickly. But if you still think they don't exist, why would they have research?
Yep, exactly.
I'm not too sure what that is, but I'm just gonna keep it going.
Look, bro, y'all didn't know this. Also, like, when you unplug something from your PC, it go like,
right?
And then when you plug it back in, look. This is the Freemason shit. Listen. You heard that? You heard what it said? Listen. It said, Mark Zuckerberg? Mark Zuckerberg? you know who Mark Zuckerberg is? Do research. But look. No, you're not. Mark Zuckerberg? See? Look, bro, y'all didn't know this.
Leaked on social media several years ago, this footage seems to show a team of men in white biohazard suits carrying the body of what appears to be a mermaid. The tail is clearly visible, and two members of the paramedic team are nearby with the stretcher. As the paramedics take the creature away, we see a slightly better view of the tail and notice how the area is cordoned off. Is this just an elaborate prank, a shoot for a TV show or film, or could this be actual footage of the government finding a real mermaid?
Alright, so I have to voice my opinion on two things. Three. Nah, two, because that does look like there's water at the bottom left of the screen. Alright, look, if that was a mermaid, how could it possibly just be spotted there with just that secretive team there? I'm pretty sure there would be a lot more people. Two, why is there these two looking paramedic people with no hazmat suit and their faces completely uncovered? Like, three, it could possibly be because they don't want too much people there to make it look like a crazy big scene. They just want it to be like a clean pickup. I don't know, that's I don't know. That's if, allegedly, if that was a real mermaid. I don't know. I just feel like it'll be a little bit more than... Let's keep it pushing, y'all.
The government has some explaining to do. The government has some explaining to do.
Smartest kid thinks that CERN blew the world up in 2008.
Maybe that fucking kid is right.
Energy cannot be created nor destroyed, only transferred from form to form. But if there are an infinite number of universes, then there's 100% chance that this happened, at least maybe in another universe, maybe not ours. Then again, there's also an infinite chance that this is our universe.
Joe Rogan and the world's smartest kid seem convinced that CERN is the epicenter of world-altering experiments. Maybe they're looking in the wrong direction. Like the true architects of reality-bending science are just toiling away, not in the spotlight of CERN, but in dark corners so secretive even their existence is a state secret. Quantum reality hacking, consciousness transference, time manipulation, experiments that don't just bend time, but fold it, altering the past through the present. Or universal simulation control. Maybe they're manipulating the parameters of our simulated universe. Tell me what you think in the comments. Where's the real Pandora's box? CERN or Secret Shadow Labs?
What if they just trying to like fast forward to the future to see when it would end, and if they could try to prevent that? Which even that shit sounds crazy, even if you had the skills and machines to do so. I don't know, bro. This is not no video game, my bad. I thought this was like some Stargate shit.
I'm in this alley in this random building, unnamed building, is just like rolling this, I don't know, barrel full of like brains or something. You see that like falling out? That's just tripping me out. He's like looking out to see if there's anyone watching. Oh,
that shit just looked nasty.
Every human being that you don't know on a personal level is not real. They're all NPCs and you can say whatever you want to them. Watch this. Hey, how's it going? Just here to drop off coupons. Sweet. Did you hear the big news?
What's the news?
Danny DeVito got an OnlyFans account.
He didn't know.
Yeah.
He gave me so much money.
$25 a month. I'll tell you right now, it is worth the money.
Is it really?
Oh, that man is short and thick. All right, have a good Monday night, huh? It's 11:30 in the morning on a Thursday. I didn't even give him coupons. Give him the instruction manual for my vacuum.
This again, bro, because it be the videos like this that be blowing these minds. No,
oh, let this guy go.
Did you not just see that?
No, are you falling?
Look up.
Where am I looking?
Look, there's a flying tree.
That shit look like New York, low key.
One of the greatest proofs that the Earth is flat. We're spinning at 1,000 miles an hour. We're orbiting in the heliocentric model of the Earth, the Sun, at 66,600 miles an hour. While doing that, we're chasing the Sun at almost 500,000 miles per hour. So we're corkscrewing and spinning through an infinite universe, never to return to where we were before. The Georgia Guidestones had a little hole drilled in the middle stone, and if you look through it, there is the star Polaris, our North Star. How can we be traveling in all these different directions, traveling infinite distances, and that star just always remains in that hole? There's no way it would be in that circle a day, let alone 40 years. But it was there.
Somebody blew it up.
Hey, yo. Somebody really did blow that shit up. Hey, man. Why would somebody do that? But that's quite some science right there, y'all. If y'all didn't know, because I sure the hell didn't know, but that was... It's on to the next one, y'all.
Using a microscope on a $20 bill, part two. What the heck? Zooming in. Part two.
Somebody said in the comments, this guy did not understand the assignment.
What are you blowing the whistle on?
Pause.
That there
boy.
Are technologies at South Pole Station that people can't even consider that exist on this planet.
Like what?
Directed energy weapon systems is something that people need to get into their vocabulary fast. The Ice Cube neutrino detector is not simply a passive listening device as presented for the science that they're claiming it to do. It also has the capacity to transmit.
Look at this. She heard me. She said something.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. Are you okay? Okay, no, you are not real. No, ma'am, you are not real. You are not real, ma'am. You are the Matrix.
Did I do something wrong?
You did nothing wrong. You did nothing wrong. but we see it for what the fuck it is. Y'all see this shit? Share, share, fucking share. Share, share, fucking share.
Bruh, it looked like she was drinking the night before, had to come into work, probably had to take somebody's shift, and she, like, got heat exhaustion, and she just, like, a little hungover, because it looked like she just, you know what I mean, falling out, or she, it might be a real hot day, you know what I mean, she a little scared, because it's a black woman, obviously, but she don't want to act out of character, might get them hands and paws put on her, like, you don't know, you know what I mean, shit, you just don't know.
Three ways that the government spies on you, and the last one will freak 98% of people out. Number one is that they listen to your phone calls. Most American phone companies hand over people's phone records to the government. And according to NBC News, the US government monitors every single phone call made in America. Number two is by watching you through your laptop or phone camera. And that's why Mark Zuckerberg covers his camera with tape. And number three is by watching you watch TV. Governments use programs that records all the audio around your TV, while also collecting information on what you watch.
Recently, I saw an alien laying on the beach surrounded by government officials. I decided to investigate the origin of the alien, and I stumbled upon what looks like an underwater alien base. Notice the circular structure deep underwater with an opening in the center.
This is like GTA.
When viewed from land, we can see what looks like a UFO, right above the alien base.
Oh my god.
When we take a closer look at the underwater alien base, we can see that there is a 27-foot opening in the center. Is this where the UFOs go to hide from us? How many more hidden alien bases are there around the world? They are everywhere.
You're telling me the government is saying mermaids don't exist? You're telling me the government is saying mermaids don't exist?
Bro.
You're
recording it right in your hand and you still can't keep the shit straight. Bro, I can't stand people, bro. Oh my god.
This freaked me the fuck out.
This fact. Okay, can I share this? I don't want to be blamed.
I doubt I could stop you.
I don't want to be blamed if you cannot get to sleep tonight.
No, I'll be okay.
Okay, all right. So, this dark energy in the future will render the universe so large, having accelerated so significantly that all the galaxies of the night sky will have accelerated beyond our horizon. And all the galaxies are the source of our knowledge of cosmology, of the Big Bang. Everything we know about the history of the universe comes to us from these galaxies. If they accelerate beyond our horizon, the next generation of cosmic explorers will only have the stars of the Milky Way to think about. There would have been an entire chapter of the universe ripped from their view. And they will be trying to contemplate an understanding of the universe without a significant part of what its past was. And so I lose sleep wondering, today, was there some previous chapter ripped from the universe itself? And here we are. And here we are, you know, touching the elephant, not knowing that, in fact, there's an elephant standing there. Or maybe there's the shadow of the elephant and the elephant has been moved. We don't know what we don't know. And this leaves me awake at night. I lose sleep over it.
I asked an artificial intelligence what the government is hiding. I asked an artificial intelligence what the government is hiding.
I don't get what that is. Hey, yo. Yeah, that is type scary, bro.
Creepy ocean theory.
It is said that humans do not only know 5% of the ocean, but it is said that the government does not want it to be known, since there are theories that they found beasts or something creepy there. It is said that these creatures are very large that could end our existence.
Damn. The government just sent out a massive signal to every phone in America. I recorded it, watch. The government just sent out a massive signal.
That's all I was saying. I had got that signal before, like, I was at work and shit was just mad weird. I thought I was tripping.
Birds look normal until you dig deeper. They sit on the wires to recharge. Birds look normal until you dig deeper. They sit on the wires to recharge. Birds look normal. Wondered why they never showed us Mammy Tissue's face.
Facts.
Probably because they don't like showing women faces, right? Wrong. What are you trying to say? Maybe you're just overthinking as usual. Wrong again.
Wow.
Ever wondered why they never showed us Probably.
Oh, really?
That's crazy!
Did you guys see the news? Yeah, government just confirmed aliens are real, so... I mean, do we have to go into work on Monday, or...
I feel like this should change a lot of stuff. Like, we should do different things, but I don't know what else to do besides buy things and watch TV.
I'm not too worried about the aliens. I feel like if they were gonna kill us, they would've done that by now, right?
I just got off the phone with my boss. I get to take a half day on Monday if I want to use PTO. Something travels across the fucking universe to contact humans, and we're using New Year's Eve rules for fucking work. It's a nightmare. I mean, who do we send to talk to them? I assume they're gonna ask for our leader, and I am not confident Biden can handle that, honestly. I don't know, maybe Joe Rogan? I don't think that's a great option, but it's legitimately the only one I can think of for some reason.
US government just tweeted out that everyone is gonna be given a mandated lead vest. The fuck does that mean?
Hey, Tommy in the other room just puked up some green gunk, so either he had some bad Chipotle or there is an alien baby in his tummy. Either way, let's keep an eye on that. Anyone else's Wi-Fi password changed to Glorbark is our overlord? The fuck was that?
I think it's coming from outside. I don't...
Okay, they're coming in. They're coming in. Holy shit. Oh my god!
Before they get through the wall, I want to let you know that I did eat all your Ben and Jerry's, but that doesn't seem that important now anymore, does it? There's aliens outside. Okay, stop crying.
What is some dark shit going on around the world right now that the public probably doesn't know about? Humanity has wiped out 60% of animal population since 1970.
Damn.
Saudi Arabia sentencing to death people who refuse to move out of their homes so that they can build Neom, their new megacity. And their relatives being sentenced to multiple decades of prison time just for protesting or merely posting their support to the cause on social media.
Damn.
Bacterial resistance to antibiotics is at an alarming level. There has already been instances of pan-antibiotic resistant strains of bacteria. This can throw us back to the pre-antibiotic era, which will effectively mean catch an infection and die. In Africa, there is a very real and very extensive slave trade going on right now, to say nothing of the other probably 40 million living in bondage. Women going missing from Indian reservations across some of the US. Many are young women and probably being used for sex trafficking. There are some interesting podcasts on the subject. 70% of the world's chocolate comes from West Africa. An estimated 1.5 million child slaves are engaged in chocolate production in Ghana and the Ivory Coast alone, not counting Nigeria and Cameroon.
That's very dark.
Conspiracy theorists live in a world where nothing could change their minds. If you show them evidence that they're wrong, they'll say that it's been fabricated by the government. If you point out how there's no good evidence for their views, they'll say that just proves how genius the conspiracy is. If you argue against them, they'll say that you're a paid disinfo agent, and if you're not interested in their nonsense, they'll say that you're a brainwashed sheep who needs to wake up. It's a completely paranoid and delusional view of the world where everyone and everything is somehow a part of the conspiracy.
Scarier, the cartel or the government?
These tortured me for a while, you know what I'm saying? 2 straight hours of torture.
The police?
Mm-hmm.
What did they do to you for those 2 hours?
They had the black bag, boom, can't breathe. They were like, where's your family at? I was like, my family's in Houston. They're like, oh, so nobody will even know you'll die if you die right now.
They can only make money off of sick people, not healthy people. Heart medicine, dandelions, and Roundup. That sounds crazy, right? But you know what? They all fit together like a puzzle. You know why? Those little yellow dandelions that grow in your yard that they tell you to hate, they're terrible. They're actually the greatest thing on the earth for your heart. The enzymes.
The Pentagon literally released video footage of aliens and nobody's talking about this. Well, we need to talk about this. Okay, now before I show the footage, I'm gonna give some quick background info. So 2 years ago, back in 2019, a bunch of alleged government UFO sighting videos were leaked. Now, many believe that these videos were fake and Photoshopped because the government just did not address them, so they kind of went under the radar and weren't talked about. Until now, because literally yesterday, the United States Department of Defense out of the blue randomly said that two of those leaked videos were actually real government surveillance footage. Okay, now I'm gonna show you these two videos and keep in mind that they're literally confirmed real by the government. Here's the first video. I don't know what device they're using to track this on, but they're clearly tracking this like triangle UFO in the sky. And here's the second confirmed real government video of them tracking another UFO in the sky. Now you're probably like, why would they confirm this information 2 years after it was leaked? Well, many believe that the government is preparing for extraterrestrial life to make contact with us. So they're slowly starting to tell us to get ready.
UFOs, bro, I feel like that's a whole nother section in itself that we need to uncover, you know what I mean? It's crazy. Aliens, UFOs, whole bunch of shit. It's a nice category. Hey, yo. Nah, that's trippy. Hey, yo. I wouldn't even think that that's the real you. Hey, yo. Nah, that's crazy. That's crazy. I ain't gonna front.
Is Elizabeth Perkins hiding in plain sight?
That's so scary. Yo. That's crazy. Alright, thanks y'all for watching this video. You know what I mean? If y'all like it, make sure y'all please thumbs up and subscribe if you're new to the channel. And y'all comment, bro. Because, you know what I mean? I need y'all comments, man. These conspiracies, they a little weak. The government ones, I can't really speak too much on those because I'm not too like familiar with how that shit works. But yo, from this, like, I don't know. I mean, conspiracy theorists alone make you think. And if you're not willing to think about some of this shit actually being real and being true, then you just a part of people that's just like being used and controlled. Like, as simple as that. But yeah, anyways, make sure y'all please leave a like and comment what y'all think was the craziest video that y'all watched up here. And I'm out.